Welcome to Unit 3 of Week 4. This unit will be giving you an introduction to Bayes' theorem. In the 18th century, Thomas Bayes came up with an approach to how statistical probabilities should change in response to new evidence. This was developed later on by Pierre Simon Laplace and Sir Harold Jeffreys. Bayes' theorem provides us with the ability to update our beliefs based on prior knowledge of factors that might be related to the event. But what does that mean? Well, very often we want to calculate the probability based on some prior information. We started looking into this when we looked at some conditional probability. Here we are going a little bit deeper into how to calculate probabilities based on that prior information. But what does this look like in practice? Well, remember first that the pipe symbol means given that. P A pipe B is the probability of an outcome A given the evidence of B. How would we express this in an example, such as the probability of getting lung cancer given that the person is a smoker? P lung cancer pipe smoker. So where can we use Bayes' theorem? Bayes' theorem has many, many applications, but here are just a few examples. What is the likelihood that a CEO of a stock market listed company gets fired given that their company's share price underperforms their competitors by more than 10% over a year? Or you've developed an app to review travel expense claims. After an audit has found that 3% of them contain errors, and it finds errors in 94% of those picked up in the audit, and 8% of those with no errors. What is the likelihood of there actually being an error given the expense has been marked as approved by your program or in error by your program? What's the likelihood of people working outside without a hat getting skin cancer in the UK? The key word here is given. Each calculation is dependent on another probability. Let's see how this is done. Let's look at an example involving medical tests. Medical tests are rarely perfect and can produce inaccurate results. We can test the accuracy of the medical test using Bayes' theorem. We know that a certain percentage of the population will, for example, get lung cancer, but we want to know how that is affected by prior conditions such as drinking, smoking, or lack of exercise. Bayes allows us to calculate the likelihood or the probability of someone getting cancer given that they smoke. So what does this all mean in practice? Well, remember the symbol, the pipe symbol, which means given. P is for probability, P A pipe B is the probability of event A, such as cancer, given B, if you know that the person is a smoker, for example. Hint, this is what we want to calculate. So P B given A is the probability of B given A. This is all divided by the simple probability of B, and therefore the formula calculates the probability of event A given the prior information we have about event B. There are three parts to this calculation. The probability of the evidence conditional on the hypothesis, P of B given A, the prior probability of the hypothesis, P of A, and the prior probability of the evidence, P given B. The example here is with some invented values. So let's assume that the prior probabilities are as such. 4% of the population have some form of cancer. 20% of the population smoke, and 60% of the people with cancer smoke, i.e. the P smoker given cancer. So the probability of the evidence conditional on the hypothesis is the probability of being, here the probability of being a smoker and you have cancer is P B given A is 0.6. The prior probability of the hypothesis, that is having cancer, simple probability of A is 0.04. Prior probability of the evidence, the prior probability of being a smoker, P of B equals 0.2. We know that 4% of the population have cancer, but in this case, what is the probability of getting the cancer given that you're a smoker. So we'll use S for smoker and C for cancer. If we put the numbers into the formula, you can see on the screen how the calculation works. You may want to pause the video here for a few seconds to go through this more slowly. Therefore, the likelihood with this formula of getting cancer from smoking is 12% based on these made up figures. In summary, we've learnt the following. You can use Bayes' theorem to allow probabilities to be re-evaluated based on new evidence. Bayes' theorem allows you to evaluate the likelihood of an event based on the occurrence of a prior event. The formula for Bayes' theorem is as you can see on the screen. To calculate the probability of event A, given the occurrence of a previous event B, we need to take the probability of event B given A, multiply that by the simple probability of A, and divide that whole result by the simple probability of B. The probability of A occurring is calculated based on the relevant event B, which has occurred. In the next unit, we will look at an example of Bayes' theorem in practice.